Yo, what's going on? Today we're going to be tackling Async number 1 for the month of November 2021 for the Minish Cap Randomizer. If you're not familiar with what an async is, all the seeds get posted into the Discord every month. Last month we didn't have any, actually. There were no seeds for October, so if you've been following these, you'll notice that I didn't do any October seeds. That's the reason why. But basically, they get posted into the Discord once a month, and all the settings are randomized. You don't know what they are until you get into the seed. And then whoever ends up getting the fastest time on each of the 5 seeds gets to change the setting for the next month. And yeah, that's about it. We're gonna just jump in and see what we've got. So nothing too crazy to start, at least so far. We have open fusions. That is the first thing we're going to note. There's a sword. Very nice. So with open fusions, that means we're going to be going to check Link's puddle right now. We're going to determine whether or not Rupee Mania is on. Rupee Mania is on. Okay. Whole bunch of other things going on there. We got spin. We got a couple scrolls. General. We got a heart. A sword. Grip ring. I think the next big thing we're going to be checking is going to be whether or not we have obscure spots enabled. And we'll do that once we go into town. From there, we're going to check the pedestal settings to see what we actually need to be doing, as well as checking our map at some point. We'll probably map check once we know what we need for the pedestal. Shop has just a piece of heart in there. I'll take it, even though most likely it's not going to be anything of value, really. Nothing in Juliet's house, okay. And here's where we're going to figure out if obscure spots are enabled. This pot right here would have a red kinstone if obscure spots are off, which it had. Otherwise, it would have a randomized item. Let's go ahead and check Tingle Trees into Courtyard. Into checking the pedestal. cane. Okay, that's a pretty good item to find. It gets me access to a lot more of the Minishex in town. Also lets me get a few other things around the world. As soon as I get a bottle, we get Cave of Flames access. Bomb bag's good too, okay. Okay, so no Royal Crypt and no Fortress. Actually, I didn't check to see if it was, it is open DHC. So nothing matters, we just need to get the stuff to beat body. The only question right now is pet items. And yes, pet items are in fact on. Because otherwise there would be a pedestal there that says, there's really nothing for you to do here. So this is a pretty standard set of items. Or it's at least a standard set of settings. Nothing too crazy. Alright, what I think I want to do is I want to check Minish checks here real quick, and then we're going to head through Minish Loop. Now that I know dungeons don't really matter, I want to kind of focus a little bit more on Overworld. I think. Oh, there was nothing in the back, right? I don't remember. Yeah, it was just Rupee, okay. Kinstone! probably doesn't matter. I mean, a lot of this really just depends on where the swords end up being, where the gust shard ends up being. Because that's like our main things right that we need right now. Swords, gust shard, bow. Possibly cape if Bosky ends up in a bad spot. Because it's not Keezy, and it doesn't look like it's Key Sanity. So we are going to have to hunt the Bosky in DHC. It still might be worth going for elements just in case we have to do pet items. But some of those pet items should be like super easy to get anyway. Because Cave of Flames and Deepwood. Of course, it would be a little bit better if Crypt and or Fortress were elements as well. But since they're not, we'll just have to deal with it if, you know, if we need three elements for a pet item. I don't know. It's not gonna be fun. Ooh, Lon Lon Key. That's pretty good to find. Okay, bracelets are nice. Definitely gonna have to find something pretty soon, I think. And that Lon Lon key might be exactly what we needed. We'll see how going through here helps us out. By getting us flippers, okay. That does get me access to more things. Specifically, it gets me access to Lake Hylia and Temple Droplets. So we're gonna do the quick droplets loop here. We don't have a lantern, We're basically just coming in here, getting the Rupee path, and leaving. It would be a little bit more profitable if we had obscure spots on as well. But without obscure spots, those waterfall rupees don't exist. Or those waterfall rupees are just rupees, so they're not going to be items. Next big thing to consider, now that we have the flippers, is maybe taking this back down to Minish Flipper Caves. Oh, there's the Gust Jar. Oh, that's interesting. No. It's interesting, but no. Not for this. Yeah, I think heading to Deepwood is probably the play here. It was interesting in the sense that I could technically continue through there. However, logically, the answer is no. Ooh, there's a sword up there. That's good to know. So there's a sword locked behind Cape and Mitz. So yeah, I definitely think Deepwood is the place to go right now. Or at least, like, Minish Flipper Caves into Deepwood. And see if, you know, we get something there. At the very least, Deepwood is a clearable dungeon. And it is an element dungeon as well. Now obviously we don't need the elements, but it's still something to consider as we search for our remaining items. Because we are definitely gonna get the cape, at the very least. We're gonna get cape, we're gonna get mitts. Because we need those for a sword. And then we need the lantern, technically. It's possible to do it without lantern as well, but we'll probably get the lantern. Which is also part of the reason why I bailed out of Droplets, is because we don't have Lantern. And the rest of Droplets is not logical until we get Lantern. And since Lantern is not necessary, we might not actually have to go back to Droplets. Okay, I will gladly take Great Spin. Great Spin this early is really nice. Because we haven't really done any combat yet, and now we're already getting Great Spin. There's boss key back there. So Gush Char is definitely locking this dungeon. 100% required to go to the back. Because we don't have enough keys for that. Now, no matter what, like, I'm gonna check the back here. The back of Deepwood is just such a powerful spot. And since we don't have Cape right now, like, we would have to do the lily pad to get that item right there. There's still a lot of keys left. You know what? That's kind of concerning, actually. There is still another key. So what I'm thinking, we do Green Shoe. See if there's a key here. Then I know exactly where the key is if it isn't. It's gotta be on Muldozer's. And then we haven't got map yet. So map's in the back. Right? Yeah, map has to be in Bosky spot then. Unless we get map here. Map or key, then there's one item left. That's what I'm getting out of this. There is one item between three spots. And out of the three spots, this is the best one to check because it also gets me an element. Vanilla element, by the way. And there's the key. Okay. Fifty-fifty shot that Muldozers has an item. I'd rather do Muldozers first than do the boss key puzzle without key. Because, you know, doing that without key means we have to do it the vanilla way, which is very slow. Muldozer fight is pretty quick anyway. And that is map. Okay. So item in the back is our item. Now the question is this going to be anything of value? Or did we come in here to get absolutely nothing? So we haven't gotten anything good here yet. At all. Okay! Well then. That completely changes everything. So now we book it. We book it to Western Wood. Do I grab anything along the way? I could. Online secret cave? I mean, we can only get one item out of there. I could do Dr. Left. I could do Dr. Left, but I don't have a bottle to go into Fountain. So I can't combo those. Yeah, just go straight to Western Woods. There's no point doing anything else. There's so many items in Western Woods anyway. So we're missing one sword. Because we know where the final sword is. We're missing Mitt's cape and bow. Alright, since we can't get into Caster right now, I'm just gonna probably end up quick warping at the end. So pushing both rocks means I have options on how to get back here later if I need to. Bottle, okay. That tells me where I need to go. We're going straight to Cave of Flames. I'm gonna skip lower Krennel. Just because I know that Krennel Beanstalk and Greyblade and all that fun stuff is gonna be so much more valuable than lower Krennel. This puts me on the path to getting two elements. Which kind of leads me to believe we might see a pet item. I don't know, before I actually go and do all of Cave of Flames here, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab the beanstalk and like all that fun stuff. But let's just see what this is. Yeah, there's nothing there. A couple more heart pieces, but that's about it. Couple heart pieces is not really worth my time right now. Like, I'll definitely grab them when I go back in there after this. Unless, of course, like, I end up getting everything else I need up here. Like, get me mitts and cape, and I won't even do Cave of Flames. Right now, I'm essentially three items from Go Mode. Mopons are nice. I'll take those. But that's about it.
We'll be right back.
What happened there? Ooh, lantern. Okay. That's interesting. That's a really interesting find. So now with the lantern. I'm almost tempted to go back to droplets. Oh, boss key is there, bomb locked, okay. Like, I just have this, like, weird feeling that this seed is being super linear for a reason. That, like, I kind of feel like following the lantern right now. But I don't want to give up on Cave of Flames just yet. I think what I might do is I might do Glee Rock. Like, finish the dungeon. But I might skip Basement. I think it's going to depend on if I find map or compass. Did I see a map or compass in the start? I don't think I did. It was just those two art pieces. Yeah, I definitely don't want to bail on Cave of Flames right now. Lantern is a good item, but it's not, like, super game breaking right now. Like, sure, yes, it gives me access to the right side of droplets, which would in turn put the left side of droplets in logic. It also gives access to, like, Hearthledge and Grimblade. Stuff like that. But there's not, like, too many spots that the lantern gets used. Which leads me to believe there's probably something else in here. But maybe not. We're gonna do the basement. I don't want to skip it. Like, I would skip this probably if we felt good about our chances of finding, like, other progression elsewhere. But right now, I don't know. Is what, 3 more items? 3 more items and a map. Plus Malari. Don't forget Malari. So that's essentially a 4th item. Baked into this dungeon. But Malari I would have gotten anyway. Because I would have been doing Glirok. Kinstone? Final Kinstone for Swamp? Okay. So as soon as I find Boots or Cape, we technically have Fortress access. That's super interesting. Alright, there is our map. So everything else here is an item. Didn't. Didn't roll up. You know, for a seed that doesn't require dungeons, sure doing a lot of dungeons. And so far, both of them have had potentially required things in them. Well, Deeplet definitely with the sword, but Cave of Flames with the caster stone. And we still have not seen Wazongli Rock or Malari. So there's still potential for even more stuff here. That is not a vanilla element, but it is an element. And nothing else there. Okay. So let's see what Malari has. Malari could very well have something good. A shield? That is potentially a good item. We're gonna go ahead and take care of that right away as we descend Mount Krennel. Ooh, boomerang is good as well. Definitely taking those. Alright, so from here we're gonna check the scrubs. I still don't want to do lower Krennel. Like, lower Krennel is okay, but we have so much else available to us right now that I'd rather go elsewhere. And I really want to see if the shield or the lantern leads to anything. Shield doesn't lead to anything. Oh, you know what? Lantern unlocks Percy. Imagine Percy having actually something good. Not just a lot of rupees, okay. We still haven't checked a lot of places. There's so many things that I could be doing. Another kinstone, okay. The only kinstone I'm really interested in right now is the Vale Falls kinstone. That gets me some really good progress. In fact, let's just check the Veil Falls real quick. Just to see if something stupid, like, is appearing there. Oh, there's a bow there. Okay. So we're getting that. So that's one less item we need. So at this point, we're missing one sword, Minish Cave. You know what? Let's just go into droplets. Why not? Following our lantern. Following our progression. This is also about the time where you stop and say, hey, I haven't been to town in a while. Maybe I should go to town. Actually, you know what? Let's check this real quick. You know, technically, we can get our third element. Getting the third element from here is going to be annoying, but we can do it. Missing map in terms of dungeon items here. that means Blue Chew could probably have something. So let's do it. If this pays off, like, this will be one of the greatest plays, but I'm sure this probably isn't going to be anything. But I'd rather do it now, while I'm here, than have to come back here later. Yeah, it was just Rupee, it's okay. Another scroll. That's already our seventh scroll. Of course, none of those seven scrolls are Rockbreaker. Okay, I'll take Magic Boomerang. There's the map. Okay, we got a whole load of nothing there, but here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go up to Red Wharf. Because here's the thing, if we have to come back here and do Octo, it's gonna be faster for me to do Octo from Red Warp than it is not. I mean, maybe this is a bad idea, but assuming, like, Cape is locked behind Octo or something, you know? In fact, maybe it's best I just do the dungeon. Just full clear it right now. I think maybe that's the best play right now. It's just doing Octo. And then we can go do the pedestal and get two items from pedestal. Cause yeah, like by the time we get to Red Warp here, we're already pretty much like all the way through the path to Octo. So I might as well just continue. Because on top of this, Ice Plane is logical right now. Because we know where the final key is. We know the final key has to be Underwater Pot. Which is obtainable without opening up the door. Which means, you know, everything here is obtainable. Do I grab the key? Yeah, I'll grab it, why not? I mean, I knew it had to be a key, but might as well. Like, just imagine boots or cape. One of those two. one of those two end up locked somewhere behind Octus. Or not even, like, maybe the mitts. Alright, there is one more check that I have to get. But we're gonna do Octo first. I feel like if we're gonna get something out of here, it's gonna be on Octo. And I know the whole setup doesn't matter, simply because I don't have boots. Not having boots changes the entire setup. But I can at least, you know, do the positioning for first couple phases. Last phase is just gonna be a crapshoot. Never lucky. Okay, one ink is fine. I'll gladly take that. And then from here I'm gonna check the pedestal, and then we'll do town stuff. Okay, not there. I still have one more thing to check in here. But yeah, if pedestal ends up being something big, that's gonna be very much in my favor, I would think. Because I doubt many people would be doing Octo for the element. Thank you. And the final item here is nothing. Cool. So that was potentially a complete waste of time. However, we did get an element from there. So here we go. 3-element pedestal check. This is pretty much like the moment of truth. Either I made the most insane play and we're getting stuff from the pedestal, or I just wasted a whole bunch of time. Well, the 2-element item is nothing. Let's see what our 3-element item is. Just a pizza heart, okay. So unless the 4-element item is something, we just wasted a whole bunch of time. You know what? I'm still fine with it. Reason I'm fine with my decision making is that, you know, there's still possibility that it could pay off. It's a very low possibility, but the final sword could still be on the pedestal. Because we only need blue sword to do palace. And we could get the blue sword from the hype cave. Thank you. There's a whole lot going on here for, you know, an open DHC seed. I'm really surprised we haven't run into any more items yet. Like, this definitely feels like one of the seeds that we should have found something by now. But we just have not found what we're looking for. Don't know what I'm looking for as, like, the next progression item. Whatever it is, we haven't found it yet. And it's probably on lower Krennel at this point. There's really not many other spots it can be. So I probably should have done lower Krennel when I was over there. Yeah, I think it actually has to be on lower Krennel right now. Whatever it is that we find. Oh wait, I still haven't done underschool. I always forget to do underschool. Like, that's a spot that it's available so early usually because you have bombs. But it's one that I always try and put off until I have blue sword so I don't have to bomb as much stuff. That sometimes backfires when I end up having to do it. There's the cape. Okay. Well, that gives me my progression. And that gives me some direction on where I need to be headed. Which is towards Fortress. Now the question is, do I go straight to Fortress without the mitts? I don't know. Are there many other cave things that I could do? There is the dojo. Yeah, that's about it right now. Once I get mitts, that opens up more stuff. That opens up blue sword once I get mitts. But I have a feeling like we're gonna run into mitts soon? Question mark? Or at least, you know, run into something in Caster. Can't possibly just, you know, run into nothing, right? Yeah, I think at this point we full clear Caster. Because I'd rather be here in Caster than be in the middle of Fortress finding progression. I don't want to have to go through Wind Ruins. Though we probably have to go through Wind Ruins. Sure, whatever item I find is gonna be like the one item that we need. So I'm probably good to just bail as soon as I find something. I think especially if it's the mitts. Oh, Vale Falls Kinstone. Yeah, we follow that. 100%. I might as well finish hiking first, because I don't want to have to do it later. But yeah, we're following that Vale Falls Kinstone. Please move. Thank you. That rope does not like me at all. Or maybe it likes me a little too much. Because it's always blocking my path. Alright, let's see. Is hiking going to have something? Nothing. Okay. Alright, here's a crazy play. Let's save here. And go check Vale Falls. And then if there's nothing in Vale Falls, we come back here and do Fortress. And that will save me the headache of rolling all the way across the map again. If we don't find anything. It's also entirely possible we find something and we still end up having to roll all the way across the map. Boots. Okay. I will take boots. And Jabberda. But that means we are going to be rolling across the map if we have to go back to Fortress. But what's good about boots is that gives me access to other things. So... and there's the mitts. Okay. Well then. Let's just do a quick check of Cloud Tops, make sure there's no sword up here. At this point, we're looking for a sword. Period. If I find a sword here, I can run straight to the other sword. I don't like that. Because that could potentially mean Yolari. We still don't have Ocarina. So no Ocarina is good. For right now, because that means the books don't mean anything. But as soon as I get an ocarina, books suddenly become pretty popular. We're not finding anything else up here, which is good. I could probably save scum this entire thing. Yeah, there's pretty much nothing here. Yeah. Only thing we got there was the book, and the book was right at the beginning, so if we actually need to do it, it's going to be super easy for us to get back there and get the book. Alright, I'm just gonna grab some stuff along the way. Oh, remember, I got boots as well. So I can use boots. But the main thing here is we want to go to Hype Cave. We want to go to Hype Cave, and we want to check Boots checks. Those are like the two main things that we're going to be doing here. If we find another sword in here, we're done. Otherwise, we have to continue and continue looking. Going to Fortress? Doesn't sound as bad right now. There it is. Okay. There it is. Alright, so we are done. Two swords in Hype Cave, dude. Two swords in Hype Cave with mitts at the top of Veil Falls. And cape on lower Crettle. Alright, so we need to get a key. There's only like, what, two spots that we can get keys at right now? Now, hopefully, we find boss key on the Darknut over here, and that'll be game. Alright, moment of truth. Small key. Okay. So we're gonna have to continue. Do I leave the king? I almost feel like I leave the king in this situation. Yeah, I could go back for the king. Like once I get the warp, I could always go back for king. Not a big deal. So ultimately, what? The only dungeon that really mattered was Deepwood. Because of the sword. The other dungeons were kind of bait. Or wait, yeah, no, we didn't need the kinstone. I I was thinking maybe we needed a kinstone from Cave Flames, but no. We never needed that. And we didn't need the shield either. If anything, the shield kind of baited me away from lower Krennel. Another key. Okay. So boss key is in a tower. Somewhere. Having great spin makes these darkness so much easier. I love it. Another key. There's the item. So now I'm pretty much thinking it's gotta be vanilla, right? The question is, which tower has the other small key? There it is. Okay. Oh no, it was not vanilla. Wow. It was actually in a tower. That was surprising. I fully expected it to be vanilla there. There it is. Okay. Not a great fight, but I'll take it because we finished the fight. Finishing the fight is better than dying, so I'll take it. Oh, nice RNG there. His body stayed still for me and didn't warp around. Pretty decent body RNG so far. Aside from that. There we go. I'll take it. Thank you. Okay. Not terrible first arm. Definitely could have been better, but I'll take it. Pretty good second arm. Okay. Now all we gotta do is play some tennis and we're done. Really? That was annoying that one of the eyes just didn't shoot. Like now we're fine. Like this should be fine. There we go. 153.59. Okay. Definitely could have been a lot better if we didn't get baited into doing all of droplets. I should have done lower Krennel first, obviously. Yeah, if I did lower Krennel first, this could have been like a lot faster. In fact, if I did lower Krennel before even doing Cave of Flames, we could have saved a whole lot of time, because both of those dungeons didn't matter. Anyway, it happens. Thanks for watching, and I will see you later.